Special operation forces cannot be mass-produced. The focus must be on the individual, not the hardware. Always striving for quality over quantity.
Here at the 371st, one of the courses that we offer is the Air Commando Field Skills course. The aircrew comes through a basic course, and this course is part of their AFSOC's Air Commando Indoctrination Program. When we get them for 15 training days, and we take them from either a new, brand new aircrew AFSOC member or an experienced legacy AFSOC aircrew. We take their experience as well as the new airman's lack of experience, and we put them on a same baseline of training.
Here we'll bring in new and veteran AFSOC aviators alike in through an advanced weapons training course. At that time, it's about 3 days in length. They go everywhere from a crawl phase where we qualify them, get them ready to handle the weapon appropriately, and then start going into a walk phase, then run phase, to where we culminate with a stress test to see how well they perform under pressure.
That advanced tactical weapons phase gives them a basic understanding of how to shoot, move, and communicate, how to draw from a holster, how to get good sight alignment, sight picture, but more importantly on how to adapt the shooting skills for AFSOC specific and unique mission sets.
The three main killers downrange is bleeding, airway, and respiration.
We take them through a tactical combat casualty care, which gives them the necessary first aid and self-aid buddy care needed on the battlefield today.
And we go to the lab we call the TOMS lab, the Tactical Operational Medical Skills Lab. We have mannequins there that bleed, they have problems with airway, problem with respirations. We teach our students how to apply tourniquets, how to control bleeding, to apply what we teach them in class. During those 2 days, 16 hours of academics and hands-on skills, the students have the confidence to save a life.
We then move into a dynamics of defensive driving.
We teach the students different maneuvers, high speed and low speed, in order to keep themselves out of harm's way while downrange.
So we'll start off with slalom. We'll do cadence braking, threshold braking, and then we'll also demonstrate braking when you're trying to make a turn. Then we'll go into ramming and pit and counter pit on the following day. All in all, the teaching brings us up to the last day, which is our FTX. The FTX will start off where they will have to do a J-turn. They'll have to go into a slalom. They'll have to go into a Y-turn, which then puts them into a corner. They'll have to do another Y-turn, which then puts them into do two more corners and a curved slalom with two bootlegs involved. At the end, where the vehicle goes down, this is where they will have to bail out of the vehicle and then bound back from there to a barricade. All the whole time while we'll have force on force, we call it, our Op 4 will be engaging them. And as we progress, you can see the driving gets better and better every time.
Next, the students move on to tactical force protection, where they learn the basics of route analysis and situational awareness in an urban environment.
That's the angry American. Now, we all know that we've seen angry Americans in the United States. That being said, as a team, you want to know your people.
Cultural sensitivity is where we're going in the world, right?
And you don't ruin that rapport or cause a situation to escalate.
Some scenarios they focus on are aircraft flight deck denial.
You need them to stand watch for something or do something. Utilize them. They're in the U.S. military. They all had this training. Utilize them the best way you can. Make sense?
Customs.
I'm doing great. We just wanted to check in for our flight.
IED awareness.
They evolve just like we evolve. They learn. We need to learn too and know what the threat is for the area that we're operating in.
And vehicle inspection.
As you see a device, call it out.
AFSOC airmen can face a multitude of different situations in a deployed environment, and this training prepares them for today's ever-changing battle space.
So keep moving forward, not just with your body, but with your mind, because the success of any mission depends on having battle-ready airmen capable of deploying in direct support of SOF operations throughout the world. Our training is the driving force behind preparing AFSOC aircrew how to shoot, move, and communicate in tactical environments. And by the time you finish, you know, no matter who you are or what role you play, technology is nothing without the people. Turning airmen into air commandos.